broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watch were so
TFPA family, parents, honored guests, members of the TIL team, colleagues, and our distinguished graduates, class of 2021. It is my honor to welcome you to the Emmett Till Fine and Performing Arts Magnet School 2021 graduation. This has been a different kind of year. We've experienced things we could never have imagined, but we are here. We are strong, we are survivors. And today is evidence of that. These students have worked, struggled, fought, and endured to be where they are today. I am proud of your perseverance. I am proud of your accomplishments. I am proud of you. I extend my warmest congratulations to all those receiving diplomas today, and I acknowledge the support of those of you who have helped along the way. To all the family and friends with us today, and to those who could not be here, we thank you for your contribution to this moment. Class of 2021, we are here today to participate in the praise and wonder at your achievements. Congratulations. Keep striving and pushing for your dreams, and remember, TIL will always be your family.
Lift every voice and sing, till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound loud as the roar. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the rising sun of our new day begun, let us march on to victory is won. Thank you.
Congratulations, Emmett Till, class of 2021. You did it. It's over. No more elementary school. You're on to the next adventure. As you move on to your next adventure, I want you to all remember, push yourself. Explore new things. You are in charge of your future. You pick out your dreams, you pick out your goals, and you reach them. There is so much more life to live. This is just the beginning.
Hey there, this is Mr. Riley. Congratulations, eighth graders. We can't wait to hear about the next great things you guys do. Congratulations and good luck.
Eighth grade, this is Mr. Lewis. I've known most of you all since you were a third grade or fourth grade. Just want to say congratulations. I know this last year at school has been different, unusual, but you all made it through. I'm proud of you as you go to high school. Just remember those values that we tried to teach you. Do your best, handle your business, okay?
Hi, my name is Ms. Morris, and I am the middle school diverse learners teacher. I just want to take this time to congratulate class of 2021 and wish you all the best of luck in your high school career.
Congratulations, class of 2021. This is the time to celebrate your accomplishments and hard work. These times are unprecedented. Consider yourselves trailblazers. As you transition into high school, just remember the skills and study habits we practiced over the many years. My goal is for you to learn skills such as inferencing, summarizing, synthesizing, and many more, and store them into your imaginary backpack. Lastly, I want to recognize three students, eighth grade students, who have shined throughout this virtual platform, who have showed a lot of growth and a lot of maturity. One, Deron Williams. Two, Justin Roberts. And three, Elijah Aaron. I'll call them my most improved players.
I want you guys to enjoy your day, enjoy your future, and live life the way it needs to be lived, positive and aspirational. And that's all I got for you. You'll see me around. Peace.
Just here to congratulate each and every one of you, class of 2021. I'm so proud of all of you, and I know you all have a great future ahead of you. We've had some great times, field trips, experiments, funny moments, and sometimes even not so funny moments that you guys made funny. I remember the saying about, like, come on, guys, and you guys changed it to come on, guys, and made it even funnier. So just so you realize, you know, I always enjoyed our moments together the last 3 years, sixth, seventh, and eighth grade, and I will always cherish the time we had together, and I'm going to miss every one of you.
Good evening, eighth graders. This is Mr. Davis, your school counselor. I'm congratulating you all on finishing eighth grade and going to high school. If you all need me for anything, please do not hesitate to reach out to me. You all know how to. Again, congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2021. I am proud of your tenacity and perseverance during a time of civil unrest and a health pandemic. You rose to the occasion. You've met the requirements. Congratulations. I wish you well, and I want you to be great on purpose, intentionally. Always strive for excellence. It is with tremendous gratitude that I have had the privilege of working with you and exploring mathematics. Please know that you can always trust the rules of math. Math is more than numbers. I wish you well in all of your future endeavors. Congratulations again, and best wishes.
First, I would like to thank all of you from teachers to friends and family. You have all had an impact on the development of the students that are graduating today, and I feel it is safe to say that I speak on the whole graduating class of 2021. And thanking you all for your efforts that you have invested in us to this day. When I first sat down to write this speech, tons of thoughts were flowing through my mind. Am I going to reminisce about past memories of importance to me? What about speaking of significant events at the school? What is the message I should try to convey? Will I pass out or just be at a loss for words? I did not think I had it in me to do this, but the most important goal I was striving for was to create a speech that was different. Not one that is so boring you could go to sleep, or one of those your journey ends here but a new one begins type of speeches, but instead offered excitement and new insight to this day. It is more about your accomplishments and the best way for me to craft inspiration and motivation in you all. This isn't a small celebration. It is one of the most significant and life-changing achievements both of you can claim to this day. Never hesitate to recognize how proud each and every one of us here today is for you to complete such a long and difficult task. Having worked hard over 10 years just for this moment, it is hard to ignore the determination, perseverance, patience, hard work, and even the sacrifice that embodies the attitudes of every graduate. I realize that after today, I may no longer see many of you. That is a painful thought. On the other hand, I am also filled with anticipation because I have no doubt in my mind that every one of you has the potential to succeed and make a difference in life. Of course, not every one of us can be rich, famous, and powerful, but oftentimes it is the people who offer words of advice that impact on the moods and quality of life in others. Throughout all my years at Emmett Till, not only have I gained knowledge from the studies I have learned, but I have learned many other lessons as well. I know that some of you question the need to attend class, but gaining knowledge is not the only purpose of it. School has helped to build social skills as well as the value to succeed. If you believe you can achieve anything and don't allow others to tell you differently, what you are capable of achieving is amazing. I encourage you, the class of 2021, to not only follow the opportunities available to you, but to follow your heart and cause of importance to you. Thanks again to all the families, friends, and teachers, and others. Congratulations again, class of 2021, and I wish you all the best of luck.
Good afternoon, family, friends, teachers, staff, and administrators. Oh, and most importantly, our parents. Give yourself a pat on the back for a job well done. I'm Amane Jones, your class of 2021, valedictorian. I would like to commemorate our class for our perseverance, diligence, and work ethics throughout this pandemic. So, congratulations, we made it. But it's not over yet. One ending is just preparation for a new beginning. Most of us have attended Till for the past 10 years, which is 1,800 days. Our experience here at Till in preschool was having fun, strengthening our gross motor skills, and riding tricycles. Primary, learning how to count, read, and take standardized tests. But the real test was middle school. Ms. Hoy taught us that math is more than numbers. Math entails an exciting mixture of symbols, figures, and variables. And when she said that, she meant it. Mr. Poole, drawing emphasis, synthesizing information, and comparing and contrasting. Mr. Z, learning about energy sources, food webs, the Constitution, and saving the Earth. Now, go take a picture hugging a tree. Dr. Peoples and Ms. Abner's vision was to meet the academic, social, and emotional needs of every student by providing rigorous and engaging instructions. At Till, pressure was applied. Now it's time for us to apply pressure. This means for us to overcome obstacles and excel with finesse at any given task due to our brute will and power. Pressure separates the contenders from the champs. Applying pressure may come as a challenge, but without challenges, we will never grow. So be brave, stand strong, and tell yourself, I am the pressure. I am the pressure that creates greatness. I am the only one who determines my worth. I have the extreme power to exceed or fall short of my own potential. When times get hard, when you do not feel like you have the motivation, look in the mirror and remind yourself that you are the pressure and that I can do this. Or we can just think about Mr. Z dancing. High school will not be easy, but by applying pressure, it will not be hard either. We must resist the pressures of the world. We must make sure to resist the urge to quit, not to take the easy way out, and most importantly, fight against temptations. Let us not forget to remain focused and not sit on TikTok for hours or listening to our favorite rappers all day. We must find the perfect balance. We must develop the mental strength to get up whenever we get knocked down. To be rare, we must do something rare. Always be true to you. Be relentless until your goals are met. Too much pressure causes cracks in the weak. But see, we are strong, all star strong, and pressure made us stronger. Persistence and preparation trumps pressure. So we must stay prepared and persistent. Persevere until we win. Now that the pressures of grade school have lifted, we will be ready for high school. We will apply all the pressure to our academics, sports, and social events. And guess what? It will take no pressure. Through a pandemic and being at home with our siblings, we made it. Learning virtually, we did that. We were not raised to fall under pressure. We were raised to apply it. With this graduating class of 2021 right here, it would take no pressure to apply pressure. So thank you all for being amazing classmates and for the fun and entertaining times. Most of us have known each other for a long time, most of us only a few years. It's fair to say that I got a good relationship with all of you, but the main reason I'm ready to go to high school is for a new experience and to meet new people. But that does not mean I would discard the memories and the friendships that we have. And hopefully you guys can say the same about me. I also want to thank my teachers from past years for putting up with us and providing us with the proper education needed to make it this far. I'm not gonna say who my favorites are because you know who you are. But finally, to my parents, thank you all for always loving and supporting me, for being that stable foundation that I needed. And it's done. I had a nice run, finished. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Greetings, faculty, administration, students of Emmett Till, graduates of class of 2021. Go All Stars. I want to say today's commencement is evidence of a heartfelt team effort. I applaud you all, including Principal Peoples. While preparing for today's commencement speech, I decided to contact the experts, my 13 and 14-year-old niece and nephew. I asked Valeria to be my adolescent affairs committee member on this regard. I was interested in knowing about the mindset of the eighth grader. During a time where technology, social media, education, and contrasting viewpoints abound, I wanted to know where you guys were. So I asked her a series of questions. Number one, what's the social media of choice? She said TikTok. I believe it's an app in which you can create a video and overlay it with music and sound effects. I was like, okay, that's pretty cool. Number two, what about style? We were pretty savvy back in the day when I was in eighth grade. I'm not quite 40 yet, but we had our own style. She mentioned high tops. I was happy. I said, yes, high tops. High tops were good when I was in eighth grade as well. Then apparently you guys have expensive taste, such as Jordans, Converse, and Vans. I'm like, oh my goodness. I loved it. I said, what about sports? She said, that depends on the school. Some basketball, some track, golf, volleyball, soccer. I said, okay. I said, finally, goals. What is the goals and the mindset of an eighth grader today? She said, there are two. One, keeping your grades up, and two, attending a good high school. So for that, I applaud the counselors, principals, teachers, administrators. You're helping to mold a positive mindset. I said, okay, I have one last question. Video games, but I'm going to have to get off the cell phone with you and call your 13-year-old brother who's entering 8th grade and Valeria's graduating from 8th grade. I'm going to have to call him on his phone to ask about video games. Now, this is where it was hilarious to me. When I was in 8th grade, I didn't have a cell phone. We had house phones, and when we wanted to speak to our friend, we would call the landline, and someone in the house would just yell their name until they came to the house phone. And if it was a wireless phone, you had a good 30 or 45 minutes before your friend had to put the phone back on the charger. Advancement. That's something I want to talk about today. You guys are going to advance from eighth grade to high school. So my nephew got on the phone. I said, okay, I have to give a commencement speech. Can you please tell me what's the video game of choice for the eighth grader? He said something funny. He said, well, if you're going to give an educational talk, I don't think you should talk about video games. But he said, if you need one, go ahead and say Call of Duty. I said, Aiden, thank you. I said, my goal was actually to speak about the future, how the students are entering a new level, new paradigm, new era, in which they're going to need a new talent, higher focus, a pristine eye. I said, why I have you on the phone? Because it's not often you get to talk to your 13-year-old male nephew on the phone. I said, while I have you on the phone, can you please tell me what you would say to the future graduates? He said two things, focus on your work and know your priorities. I said, that's pretty cool. So Valeria outlined your present, and my nephew Aiden helped me to segue into your future. So let's talk about that. There is an author who wrote, I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and I know that right well. And it brings up this imperative thought. There are two things you really need to know as you move forward. What is your gift and what is your passion? A few years ago, I had the opportunity to attend a recording of the Steve Harvey Show. At the time, he invited grad students and undergraduates from colleges. Somehow, the topic of gifts and passions came up. In this, he made the distinction that a gift is something that comes naturally. It is something that your friends or family around you may not be able to do, but you can do it in the blink of an eye. It's innate. Your passion is something you enjoy, but it's external. It's outside of you. You chase it. So he gave a recommendation, an economic recommendation, but a recommendation nonetheless. He said, use your gift to make money and fund your passion. That was interesting. I took note of it, obviously, because I'm saying it here today. But I think your gift has a greater purpose. I think somehow it ties with your purpose for your life, God's and the Creator's purpose for your life. There's another author who wrote, your gift will make room for you and put you before great persons, great kings, queens, professionals. But I think it's going to take you a step further. I think you will become a great athlete, a great author, scientist, doctor, lawyer. But you have to focus on honing your gift. How do you do this? High school. In high school, you're going to be afforded the opportunity to choose your classes and electives. Focus. Which classes do I want to select to refine my gift? You have to attend those classes. You have to make good grades in those classes because high school is 1 4-year audition for your future job, life, career. There are some people who even meet their spouse in high school. So again, I ask you, what is your gift? It's imperative for you to know those things. So I want to focus on you being fearfully and wonderfully made. Why wonderful? Let me leave you with a few descriptors. You're from Emmett Till, so you're an all-star. That's one descriptor. You're unique. There's another. You're talented. You're gifted. There's another. You're marvelous. There's one more. And you're wonderful. Why wonderful? You're made from a wonderful plan through the most wonderful of creators. So I'll leave you with a lasting homework assignment. These are three things, and I hope you text it to yourself, email, write it down. Number one, write down your gift. Number two, your passion. Number three, your life's plan. Knowing that your gift is tied to your purpose, do not water down your gift for anyone. Set a standard of excellence for yourself. Do not allow your mind to be deterred or entertained by things such as social media, arguments, conversations, fighting. Don't allow it to hold your mind hostage. Your mind is very important, and your heart, because your gift is tied to your life's purpose. And when in doubt, remember you are the future. You're a future leader. You're a future author, athlete, scientist, doctor, orator, entrepreneur. You are somebody. You are special. You went to Emmett Till, where excellence is an expectation. You are an all-star. So I want you to be encouraged as you transcend to this advancement, this next level of high school. And remember, what is my gift? What is my passion? And refine your focus. Thank you, class of 2021, for allowing me to be a part of this today. You are somebody. Go all-stars. Thank you.
Grade graduates, class of 2021, I would like to conclude today's graduation with a few words to you. As you proceed to the next chapter of your lives, I will offer the following ingredients for success. Number one, operate with integrity. If you carry out your responsibilities consistently to the best of your ability, you will always win. Number two, courage. In the face of adversity, and even tragedy, try to remember the reasons for optimism. Never be afraid to ask for help. Number 3, follow your instincts and curiosity wherever they lead and embrace opportunities. Number 4, be bold and take risks and don't let the fear of failure stop you. Failure is a part of life. It's another way to learn. Change is a part of life too. At times it's frightening, but we should see it as a chance to explore and test our limits. Above all, enjoy what you do. Although this year may have been challenging, you made it. Congratulations. Go out and show the world who you are. Now presenting the graduating class of 2021.
Elijah Aaron. Siobhan Braxton. Lauren Brooks. Charisma Burns. Zakoya Chairs. Raymarion Cotton. Deja Courtney. Nevaeh Cuthred. Safari Dern. Ryan Durr. Janante Evans. Takoya Ford. Deviante Johnson. Chris Joyner. The valedictorian, Amane Jones. Keon Jones. Nicholas Jones. Kenaya Matthews. Jakaya McNair. Jamad Muhammad. Elijah Payne. Justin Roberts. Alyssa Sally. Ariana Sanderson. George Serrano. Don DiCaprio Smith. The salutatorian for the class of 2021, Zachary Stewart. Ashanti Tyler. Aaliyah Watley. Terry White. Kimari Willett. Cameron Williams. Deron Williams. Jamari Wilson. Diamond Wire.
The moment we have all been waiting for. Parents, guardians, family, friends, and the graduating class of 2021. The Emmett Till Fine and Performing Arts students have completed all the requirements for graduation as set forth by the State Board of Illinois and the Chicago Board of Education. I hereby present you the graduating class of 2021. Students, you may now turn your tassels. Congratulations, you did it.